Goedenavond en welkom, baie dankie dat allemaal ingeskakeld het hier by Klipkop. Ter ander gewoonte op 'n sonndagaand, ongelukkig met die beurtkrag, het dit my 'n bietjie rondgeneek. Soos julle kan sien, ek het nog eers my mikrofoon opgestel nie, byt net gou vas. Het smaak en nou die ouwe is een bykie in my gezicht gewees. Ek kan ook een bykie skuif ook. In elke geval, dit is koud hier so in die Weskus. We gaan het daar by julle. In laasweekse episode het ons gelees hoe Jan die manne begin een gevangenis neem. Daar het slawe verdwijn, daar is geloof in die slawe gehuisves. En daar is gevangen geneem Shasher, Pieter Otengo, Osahua en Gogosua. En Gogosua smaak mis is gedurende die tyd, is hy ergens vrygelaat. Ek het nie precies raak gelees waar nie, maar hy smaak my, hy is vrygelaat, maar die ander klomp sit nog. En ons gaan nou volgende leer van Harry, hoe hy in gevangen geneem is. Vanaand is wanneer alles gebeur. Maar voordat ek inspring in die boek, wil ek eers luister vir die mense in die kleedskolom. Ek sien Domina Morgul was heel eerste hier so gewees. Die episode is vanavond speciaal vir haar. Sy wacht nou al so lang vir hierdie episode. Ek is al een bykie skyns op hier. Bykie meer in die middel sit. Ja, hy sal werk. Mike Simpson, goeie naand Mike Simpson. Ek neem aan Phineas daar ergens in die achtergrond. Hy sê ek het al een dislike. Wie is dit? Ek weet nie, dit is seker een van die heides. Een van die manne wat aan mekaar verkondig, jy moet jou geskiedenis ken, maar nie hulle eie geskiedenis ken nie. En RJJ, RJJ. Naand Klip Mike en Fini. Ja nee, ek smaak hier die title. Dis tyd, Fien. Ach, Domina, dis tyd. Struteer alweer. Ek het my kopie troos, ook hier by my. Het Fini nie vir ons een teekie gemaakt. Een teekie en een maamheidbrood met een bykie kaas op. Klink toch die heerlik so op een sondag aand. Maamheidbrood en thee. Ok, ons trek by Julie 16:58. En hierdie camera is baie, baie nabij ingestel. Ek het om hopeloos te nabij ingestel. Kom ons kyk, gaan die beter so lyk. Ek dink so sal allemaal beter kan sien. Op die eerste, today almost all the Hottentots belonging to the camp of the Carpmans and Harry, who had been searching for the fugitive slaves, returned without any reported that they could find none. Thereupon all the prisoners and their wives began to weep and wail lustily, as they had been told that they would not be released until all the slaves had been brought back to us. They evidently saw little chance of this happening just yet, partly perhaps because they were unable to recover the fugitives from those to whom they had been given or sent, and by whom they had already been taken far inland. The interpreter Dumas, however, apparently maintains that they had never seen the fugitives who had run away of their own accord. We showed him that we did not believe. Yeah. On the contrary, we feel that we are correct in presuming the above, for the Hottentot women were too familiar with the slaves in the beginning and gave them many things. The result is that they have to be satisfied to remain in captivity until we recover the slaves or know what has really become of them. This made the interpreter Dumas hang his head and seem much depressed, as also Eva, who said that the Hottentots would kill her if we did not release Shashar. En ons gaan later net 'n bietjie lees van Shashar. Hy is glo die hoofkaptein van die Kaapmans. The son of the chief of the Kaapmans. She was told to keep within the fort and that if anyone harmed her, the commander would have him captured as well. To set the minds of the hostages at rest, the commander in person told them to have no fear, for no harm would come to them, and said that everything was being done to recover the runaway slaves. They were given some tobacco, bread and brandy, which seemed to cheer them up somewhat. So dis baie drama. Kom ons kyk hierdie volgende stuk. Dis nou die tweede, dit gaan ook, ek moet ook alles deurlees. Mense, ons gaan nie vanaand deur 'n maand kan kom nie. Ek hoop eintlik ek kom by die stuk uit waar hy gearresteer word. The second same northwesterly wind, unfavorable for the departure of the ship, the Honorable Willem Bastink therefore came ashore again, and in his presence the interpreter Duman, in the name of the fat captain of the Kaapmans, Gogosua, proposed to the commander that as it was impossible to recover the rest of the slaves, Shashar, the chief's son, should be released, in return for which he would bring a present of good draft oxen, etc. It was suggested that in his place Harry should be made prisoner and all his cattle taken from him, for he had after all obtained these from the Chinookwas when he was sent inland with the company's copper, and had delivered only 10 to the commander, which was indeed true. Moreover, 5 years ago, Harry had caused the herd boy to be slain by Jan Kou. Nou maar, hulle sê nou hier, dis definitief Jan Kou, waar is ek nou? Hulle sê nou hier, dis definitief Jan Kou, maar later dan smaak my as die mense nie meer so seker nie. Who was now our prisoner? Oof. And by another named Bohubo. Nou smaak my, Bohubo is eintlik die ou, maar ek het nog nie ver genoeg gelees tot dat daar nou finaal gebesluit was wie dit gedoen het. Maar dis tussen daai twee ouens is die skaapwagtertjie vermoorder. Who was still with him and had thereafter carried off all the company's cattle. Jan Kou had also stolen the 15 sheep last found to be missing, and they were now among Harry's flock. Dis natuurlik toe die Honorable Cunius hierso was. As a matter of fact, all that Harry possesses belonged to the company. Apart from this, he was just a poor wretch and merely chief of the watermen or strandlopers here at the Cape. En dit is baie waar toe Jan van Riebeek hier so aangekom het, toe het hy niks gehad. Duman was thereupon asked whether this would please the other Hottentots, namely the Gorachohukwas, Chadinghurinas and also the real Saldanas, such as the Chinookwas, Kochokwas, etc. And he replied, yes, and that it was not to be doubted. When he was told that their chiefs should themselves visit the commander to consult with one another on the matter, he replied that only the Gorachohukwas, Gogosua, the chief of the Kaapmans, and a certain Sigenman named Ankaisua, rich in sheep, lived hereabout, and that to them alone the land of the Cape belonged, so that whatever they decided, the others would be satisfied as long as Harry could be made away with. So die hele Kaapland is teen Harry. He was told that the chiefs of the Kaapmans and the Gorachohukwas with Sigenman should come to the commander to consult together. He thereupon left to report this to them. Ek dink ons gaan nou aan. The Honorable Willem Bastink again came ashore at the request of the commander to consult with him in the council about the present state of affairs. The following resolution was today adopted. Nou, maar Jesus nou waar hulle gaan nou besluit, Harry is die ou. The council, assisted by the senior merchant Willem Bastink and the skipper of the Maria, who had lately witnessed most of the events which had occurred, considered from all the circumstances that no more of the fugitive slaves would be recovered, just as reported by the Hottentots, who had been out searching for them and who pretended that they were unable to find any more. As a result, the hostages were beginning to show signs of desperation, fearing that they would have to die, especially as the Gorachahuquas, or tobacco thieves, who caused us much trouble, has fled inland, and the Hottentots therefore had no means of delivering the chief of that tribe into our hands. The point had now been reached at which the seizure of Sasha had become widely known throughout the country. This caused the greatest possible sensation. While the question of the slaves deserting had reached the stage where it had to be settled. Nou maar hierdie Sasha ou, dit is die fat captain Gogosua se oudste seun, so hy is half die prins van die Kaapmans. So dis 'n baie baie belangrike figuur in hulle stam. The prisoners themselves requested this. They were offering a large number of cattle and sheep for their liberty. They wished to make a new and permanent peace and alliance with us on condition that first of all, Harry and all his cattle should be seized, because he had been the initial cause of all the mischief. He caused the company's cattle to be stolen and the Dutch boy David to be killed 5 years ago, and further stole whenever he had the opportunity to do so. Only lately, when the Honorable Cunius was here, he had stolen 15 sheep which are still in his kraal, besides all the cattle bought with the company's copper, tobacco and pipes entrusted to him 3 years ago, when he had delivered only 10 to the commander and enriched himself with the rest, so that virtually everything that he possessed belonged to the company. After all this and more had been considered and deliberated upon, it was resolved to entice Harry into the fort by means of fair words and to seize him and bring him face to face with the others to hear them speak against one another. Ons gaan nou hofverrigtinge hê in die Kaap. And in that way to discover everything. And further, as soon as he was in the fort, to have his cattle at the Salt River seized for the company and brought to the fort by the sergeant and some soldiers. This was done and resolved in the Fort of Good Hope on the above date. Jan van Riebeek, Willem Bastink, Klaas Fransen, Bordung, Roelof de Man, Jan van Harwarden en Abraham Gabbema. Nou hier is waar die story nou al klaar begin het dik raak. Ek dink dis hopeloos te veel opwinding vir so 'n kort tydjie. Die bom gaan nou bars. Hulle gaan nou Harry se veel ophaal. Dis waarvan ons gewag het. Ek sien Bebop Williams as ook Belville Piet het gejoin in die chat. Mense, ek gaan net so halwe se gereek hier ook, ek spring nou weer terug. Ek sien ek moet meer gereeld korter breuke vat. Nou, een ding wat ek vanaand geleer het, wel, ek het van tevore al gesê, maar dis nou duidelik. O, Kieter! Dis nou duidelik dat Harry se status hier aan die Kaap is nie regtig waar wat ander mense wil voorgee dit is nie. Wat ook al duidelik geword het vir my in hierdie hoofstuk, is dat die strandlopers en die Kaapmans is eindelijk dieselfde stammetjie. Maar Harry se klein groepie is amper soos bannelinge, soos nou, hulle is die gemors van die stam, wat hulle sê, man, loop bly daar op die vlak, moet nie tussen ons bly nie. Wil jy kom hallo sê vir die mense? Kom, maar ek gaan jou gauw weer afjaag. Klim. Ga jy sit en ras die hele tyd terwyl ek lees? Oh. Oeh, die lewe is oor verskrikkelijk vir die kat. Kat moan die hele tyd. Moan, moan. Mike Simpson sê keel hole and then a firing squad. Klipkat. Baie, baie skerp. Oké. Okay. Ek moet vinnig double clutch, ek wil nie julle tyd mors nie. So spyt, ek moes laat begin het, ek sien iets minder kykers for obvious reasons. Ek het dit nou een gekookte eierikie ook gepik, so as het dalk een wind breek, vraag om verskoning. Oké, okay, let's go. Om ek nip gauw die ouwkie. Harry Mang vanavond. Koffie klaar. Hierdie ding rook nog. Het rook al een kant, haal hy. Sit hem op die boek. Wat, ek dink ons trek nog steeds by die eerste of die tweede, is nog vroeg in die maand. Die derde. Pursuant to the above resolution, the sergeant was sent out to carry out the instructions carefully, and by fair words succeed in getting Harry inside the fort within the hour. Here the latter was well treated, as was customary. Of his own accord he joined the other prisoners. The sergeant meanwhile was dispatched once more to fetch the kettle, but this did not pass off so quietly, for some of Harry's men offered resistance, and the sergeant, who was mounted, was almost pierced by an assegai. He avoided the missile and wounded the Hottentot in the legs with a charge of shot, so that the latter was unable to walk, while another whom he wounded in the eye with a shot from a pistol fell down at once. Ons gaan later aan het lees, die ouwe is, hy het net met omgeval, omdat hy oorlede is die tyd. A subnota hieronder, as hy sê hierso, here we have the first serious clash between Van Riebeek's men and the natives. It was becoming increasingly apparent that the commander would have to revise his policy of peace at any price. Nou nadat hierdie ou nou geskiet is in die oog, thereupon the rest all fled, and the sergeant successfully brought the cattle and sheep to the fort with the help of soldiers without encountering any further resistance, so long as there was one Hottentot in the neighborhood of our men, though numbering 20 or 23, were unable to drive the animals. They were obliged to drive the company's cattle before and behind those of the Hottentots in order to let them graze together and to get them more easily into the kraal in the evening, a move that went off fairly well. From this it is evident that these animals will have to be guarded by a large body of men while out grazing if they are not to be stolen again by the Hottentots. Nou hier is twee goeikies. Die eerste ding is, as far back as 1510, when De Almeida visited Table Bay, it was noticed that the cattle obeyed the whistle of the Hottentots. So die vee wou vir die... Die vee luister net vir die kooi se fluit, nie vir die Hollander se fluit nie. After this had been done, Sharshad and the interpreter Duman were brought into the commander's office and in presence of the council, assisted by the Honorable Bastink, were asked whether they still stood by the charges they had brought against Harry from time to time and would dare to repeat them in Harry's presence. Nou, maar hulle moes nou allemaal gesê, Harry moet opgesluit word, hy is die hoof instigator. Nou, ons het nou hier so die eerste groot ondervraagsessie, dit is Sharshad en Duman wat teen Harry en Eva getuig. Eva is half tussen mekaar, maar hulle gaan nou in mekaar se hare inspring. Sharsher was informed that Harry had charged him with the same things and the council accordingly wished to know which was the guilty one and who was sincere and who not. Sharsher said as much as he could and more through Dumont, a dissembling rascal, declaring, "You just bring Harry here." Thereupon the latter was at once brought in, assisted by Eva. Nou hier kom Krutua en Harry saam in. They babbled vigorously. Dumont tried to exonerate the Carpmans of all the charges, but Eva said, "I shall tell the whole truth. Harry admits that his people stole the cattle and murdered the boy, but the Carpmans also shared in the stolen cattle. Indeed, after Harry had had the cattle for a few days, the Carpmans, of whom Sharsher was one of the chief men, stole them from him." Nou ek weet daar's 'n sekere ander Engelsman wat 'n boek geskryf het, The Lie of 1652, waar hy sê hierdie spesifieke saak is 'n cold case, maar hierso kan ons dan self sien. Harry homself sê, "Okay, ek is skuldig." Wel, Eva sê deur. Maar daar het hulle dit so, tot Harry homself sê, hy die laat doodmaak en die skaap gesteel. Maar vir een of ander rede wil The Lie of 1652 vir ons vertel dat dit 'n cold case is. Upon this, Dumont in extenuation submitted that a feud had existed between the Carpmans and Harry's people at the time, and that it had been an act of war. Eva then asked, "If the Carpmans wished to appear so honest, why did they not return the cattle?" Goeie vraag. "They are as great thieves and rogues as Harry's people, for as soon as anything had been stolen, they plotted together, and they shared the booty. To give Harry all the blame was certainly not right." These words were spoken by the interpreter Eva in Dutch, and she added, "The person who killed David is Klaas, a Hottentot of Harry's tribe. He has since disappeared." A little while after, when Harry had joined the others in a room and had also been locked up, Dumont came to the commander, who had gone outside, and asked why we had not killed Harry at once. On this he was answered that if Harry so fully deserved it, why did they not do it themselves? They had him now in their power, and he was locked up in the room with them. Hier was nou weer wette rondom verdediging. Mense, hier is bitter baie leeswerk vanaand. "Since we fear that in present circumstances and in consequence of the action which is still proceeding, the natives may conspire to attack the freemen and the company's servants and cattle, and as the present garrison may prove too weak to beat off an assault because of the fact that counting all the agriculturists, gardenists, smiths, plough and wagon makers, carpenters, masons, outside in the wood, within and on the Robben Island, we number no more than 97 persons, including 19 or 20 sick left behind by the ships to leave. The council, assisted by the Honourable Willem Bastink, after consideration of the matter, accordingly resolved to strengthen this settlement for a time by drafting 20 soldiers from the Prince Willem until these matters have been settled and a fresh peace and alliance made with the Hottentots. We trust that this will be accomplished before the arrival of the May ships from the Fatherland, so that this additional burden on the company, which rests heavily at present, will be of short duration. It has also been resolved to draw 1,000 pounds of powder and 200 hand grenades from the above mentioned ship, also to mount the 2 small metal guns of the Maria on the brick radeau Korenhoop in the middle of the cultivated lands of the freemen." Waar het Korenhoop gestaan? As ons hier na die, hier so is die fort, hier so is die berg, duinhoop is hier so, hier so is die kanon, so hulle gaan nou hierby, hier is Hollandse tuin in Groeneveld, hulle gaan nou daar by Korenhoop, gaan hulle twee kanoniekies opsit, van die skip Maria. En dit is het, ons is nou eers by die derde dag van juli, en het nou al klaar so baie gebeur. In elk geval, daar is 20 mense getrek van die skip af, dis maak my hierdie Honorable Willem Bastink, hy bly nou my eers, want dis nou groot goed wat gebeur hier aan die Kaap. Kom ons kyk, die vierde, jy sê net Willem Bastink het aangebly, nou daai Hedy en Eva teen Duman en Shashid was die eerste ondervraagsessie gewees, hier is nou by die tweede ondervraagsessie, of die tweede groot geval, is Pieter Otengu, wat ontslaan word. Shashir and Duman submitted that the latter did not go to the camp of the Kaapmans to ask them to come hither with all their huts and livestock in order to discuss with the others a new permanent alliance and suggested that one of the hostages should be liberated for the purpose as there were no longer other Hottentots whom they could trust in the neighborhood. They proposed that Pieter Otengu, Shashir's brother, Shashir en Pieter Otengu is broers, en hulle is die twee seuns van Gogosua, die fat captain, leier van die Kaapmans. Brother and younger son of the fat captain should be sent. After consultation with the Honorable Bastink, it was decided to do this and to take the risk involved. As Shashir and Osahua of the Kaapmans and Harry and Janko, the principal hostages, would remain here. Pieter was instructed to assure the chief of the Kaapmans, Gogosua, and Ankahisua, the great shepherd of Sichenman, that we had no evil design towards them and that we regretted that one of his people had yesterday been shot dead by the sergeant. Nou maar, hier so is nou waar daar nou vir my so begin een vraagteken. Daar was gesê dat hulle gaan uit na Harry se kamp toe en Harry se vee gaan daar op beslag gelê word. Nou word daar gesê, dat want hierdie ouwens is, dis Kaapmans nou hierdie, dis nie hierdie se man, hierdie is Kaapmans, that one of his people had yesterday been shot dead by the sergeant. Nou hoekom sal, as hierdie so stink so wat hy stink, hoekom sal die Kaapmans hierdie se vee verdedig? This would not have happened, however, if they had not in the first instance hurled assegais at him, and that we were fully prepared to settle all differences between them and us in order to form an unbreakable alliance with them. Thereupon he left with some tobacco as a present for their womenfolk. No! Jy sien, ek het jy oorspronklik hier geskryf, die strandloper vrouwe kom eis vergoeding. Maar later dan raak het nog meer duideliker in die boek, dat hierdie is nie strandloper vrouwens, dit was Kaapman vrouwens gewees. In the afternoon, Harry's people with their wives and huts approached, and after asking us for a place to settle, were shown a spot under the guns of the fort on flat land below the lion's rump, close to the thickly overgrown dunes, where they made their camp. Among them appeared the three wives and sons of the Hottentot who had been killed, requesting that they might have back their cattle and sheep, which were still among Harry's cattle, as well as some copper and tobacco, in compensation, as it were, for the loss of their husband and father. They were told that the sergeant had been attacked first and had fired at the Hottentot in self-defense, while the Dutch boy David had been cruelly and wantonly murdered by the Hottentots, for which no atonement had yet been made. Every effort would, however, be made to ensure that they and all the Hottentots and we ourselves received satisfaction as soon as the camp of the Kaapmans, Ogogosua, and the huts of Ankaisua had been moved hither, when negotiations would be commenced with a view to establishing a closer alliance, and that all differences would then be settled. Thereafter we might live as good friends. Dit maak nou die vraagteken vir my nog 'n bietjie groter. So dit smaak my wat die story nou klink is van die vee was Harrison gewees en van die vee was die Kaapansin gewees. In the evening, the interpreter of the Kaapmans, Duman, reported that the fat Captain Gogosua and a few other principal men of the Kaapmans would be at the fort tomorrow to confer with us as aforesaid. Nou, hier is nou die volgende verdrag gesluit met die Kaapmans. En jylle kan sien, hier is een hele elle lange lys van mense. Maar ek dink is nou eers tyd vir die smoke break. As die stream al raad, ek sien hy gaan so elke nou en dan rooi blokkie, maar lyk nie te gereeld nie. Elke 15 minuut is so 'n paar trek. Ek weet nou nie, ons by die 4 of die 5de. Ons trek nou by die 5de vandag. Hierdie maand gaan lank wees. Ek sien Finnie Simpson het toe ook om 'n lou sê. Het Finnie vir ons 'n teekie gemaak. Maak my keelkie nat, God mense, is baie leeswerk vanaand. Ek wil graag stadiger lees, dat ek beter kan sin maak. Maar as ek stadiger lees, kry ons nog minder gedaan in 'n uurse tyd. My equities, Johan van B, ook goedenavond, Johan van B. Oké, okay. So daar is van die ouwens is nou losgelaat, of een van die ouwens is losgelaat, Pieter Otengo, en hulle het nou vir Gogosua Lobaal, en weet, al die hoofmanne daar rond, al die mynkonyne van die Kaapmans is nou geloop haal, en hulle gaan nou sit rondom 'n tafel, en hulle gaan nou bespreek, wat is die pad vorentoe. Nou, voordat ek met hierdie verdragstory beginne eers lees het, wat ek vir myself gesê, okay, wag. Dit is natuurlik baie moontlik dat wat die story in die boek nou nie heeltemal so afgegaan is wat dit in die werklikheid afgegaan het. Hierdie skikking hierso, wat hier bereik is, hier word 'n skikking bereik. Het ek vir myself gesê, klink op die ouend van die dag, as die skikking, klink dit gebalanseerd? Of klink dit 'n bietjie eensydig? Nou, jylle kan vir my sê of dit na 'n gebalanseerde skikking klink, of na 'n eensydige skikking klink. Hulle het tot genommer, dis amper soos wette, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Nog 'n kortiekie vir netto, net wat 2 puffs kan vat. Ok, sit nog weer op die boek. Hier begin die hofverrigtinge. Pieter Otengo returned towards the midday with the fat captain, father of Sharship, and captain of the Kaapmans, as well as the following principal men of their people, to negotiate a peace, and they were made to sit down in the hall according to their rank as pointed out by Duman. En hier begin ons nou met Gogosua, the fat paramount captain of the Kaapmans, and the following brought from prison, Osing Kima, or Shasher, eldest son and successor of Gogosua. Nou sien jy, die Shasher is nogal 'n groot ou. Otengu or Pieter and Kuna alias Jan, sons of Gogosua. Dan gee hulle nog hierso 'n lang lys. Ek het die lys actually neergeskryf. Kom ek wys gou vir julle. Want ons gaan later dan ek gaan hom net so maak dat julle ook kan sien. Nou, hierdie was nou by die Kaapman sittings. Nou, Gogosua was nou die groot kaptein, dan het hy drie seuns, Kuma of Jan, Otengu of Pieter, of Osinkima, Shasher. Nou, maar hierdie is nou die drie seuns, en dis maak my hierdie ou is die, Shasher is eindelijk die ou om wie te praat. Gogosua was net so half in 'n oversight rol, en dan is al hierdie ander mense, is nou deel van die Kaapman sitting. Wat ek snaaks vind is dat Jan Kou ook op die lys is. Want terwyl daar net al gesê was dat Jan Kou 'n strandloper is. With one accord they requested earnestly that a permanent peace and close alliance might now be negotiated between them and the Dutch and that all previous disputes might be settled. They protested that they would rather be killed in the fort than leave without having concluded a proper peace, every one of them offering his head and neck to be cut off for that purpose. The commander and council, assisted by the skipper of the yacht Maria, Klaas Fransen Bording, resolved to enter in such an agreement, but in order to keep them on good terms with us and not to arouse any suspicion that we mistrusted them, it was considered advisable to make no mention of continual hostages, as they had become had come to us of their own accord to beg and pray for peace. Nou, ons het in die vorige episode gelees, hulle sit met die gedachte van continuous hostages. After we had recapitulated all the trouble they had caused us from time to time, etc., negotiations were commenced and the following conditions were mutually agreed upon, both parties promising to abide by them permanently and inviolably. Hoe ook al. Eerstens, whatever the Kaapmans have done to us and we to them, including the shooting of the Hottentot the day before yesterday, which happened in the fury of the encounter, shall be considered forgotten and forgiven as if it had never happened, and as if the dead Hottentot had never been alive. Regarding the murder of the Dutch boy David 5 years ago, that has to be settled with Harry and his people. These Hottentots are innocent of the crime and will have nothing to do with Harry. Nou daarmee punt 1 kan sien nou, hulle word definitief geïdentifiseer as twee verskillende groepe. Maar, bietjie later, onthou net, soos definitief, daar is twee verskillende groepe, die Kaapmans moet vergewe die moord van een van hulle ouens, en dan die veewagtertjie se moord, gaan nog uitgeklaar word met Harry, maar soos die veewagtertjie se moord, gaan nie op die rug van die Kaapmans lê nie. Whenever the Kaapmans cause us, or we them, any trouble or injury, each party shall punish his own, in the presence of the chief or of commissioners from the injured or offended party, with the advice of both parties, according to the nature of the case. Dit klink vir my redelijk 50-50, ek meen. The Kaapmans shall permanently dwell on the eastern side of the Salt River and the fresh river Liesbeek, as the pastures on this side are not even sufficient for our own needs, except only if natives from the interior attack them, when they may proceed past the fort and retire behind the Lion Mountain under our guns. Nou maar, so dis basis van die VOC bly op daardie stuk grond, hulle gebruik eksklusief daardie grond, en dan kyk nou hierso, as ek hom nou weer op die desktop sit, hierso lê Duinhoop, en hierso is die Liesbeek rivier. So Jan sê, hulle kom nie in hierdie area nie, behalwe as hulle aangeval word, dan kan hulle hierso terugtrek, dan kan hulle al hulle goedjies, kan hulle hierso kom wegkruip. En dan is hulle heeltemal gebeskut, want hierso is Tafelberg in die pad, hulle kan miskien hier probeer deurkom, aan die linkerkant, want dan is hulle ook vastgedruk, so dit is een baie veilige plek daar. So daar word vir hulle, weet, een veilige hawe gegee. Natuurlijk op die conditie dat hulle bly oos van die rivier, so lang so ver as moontlik prakties. Nommer 4, the Kaapmans shall ensure that their cattle and sheep do not trespass on the grain fields of the company or of the freemen. If found trespassing by our men, they may be shot and are to be left there until an inspection can be carried out by a commission drawn from both sides. Whenever any slaves or servants of the honorable company or freemen desert, the Kaapmans shall, on being informed thereof, do their utmost to recapture the fugitives and deliver them to the commander at the fort. For every recaptured slave, they shall receive as much copper as is paid for one head of cattle. They promise also to do their best to recover the 10 slaves still at large. They shall henceforth no longer obstruct the Saldanhas and other natives coming from the interior, but invite them to visit us for the purpose of friendly trade and intercourse with us. If they fear any trouble from such natives from the interior, they may take refuge under our protection in terms of Article 3. En julle hoor, dit is 1658, maar dit lees soos 'n moderne kontrak. The Kaapmans shall henceforth supply, against payment in copper and tobacco, 10 head of cattle and 10 sheep for every large vessel calling here, 5 of each for yachts and flutes, and shall deliver to the fort every Sunday 2 head of cattle for the garrison and 2 sheep for the commander and the officers of the fort. In return, one of the Kaapmans, assisted by the interpreter Duman, may board every vessel and receive 2 bags of bread and rice, 2 or 3 pieces of pork and a small keg of brandy. So, hierdie nommer 7 en nommer 8, ek kan nie sien dat die Kaapmans of ingestem het daartoe nie, of ernstig was toe hulle ingestem het nie. Want ek kan onthou in die verlede, was hulle net so harde gat soos hierdie gewees, en gesê, ons sal nie vee in julle verkoop nie. It being agreed that all the above articles shall be upheld and caused to be upheld, they were mutually approved by shaking of hands and being binding upon an inviolable to both parties, who undertook to carry them out strictly. Thereupon the hostages were liberated, and the natives, as a token of their intention to observe the provisions of the agreement, presented the commander with 10 fine head of cattle and 9 fine sheep, for which they would not accept anything in return though they were offered copper, etc., and were pressed to accept it. They said they would not leave before the commander had promised to accept that gift without giving them anything in return, and as a token of inviolable alliance, otherwise they would be under the impression that no permanent peace has been made. They all preferred to stay in the fort and were willing to be killed rather than leave without a final peace having been concluded. The conclusion of peace with the Kaapmans and the promise to observe the conditions thereof were thereupon jointly affirmed by the shaking of hands. Thereafter, Harry also appeared before us with 9 or 10 of his people to treat for peace. The murderer of David was pointed out in the presence of all, and it was decided to leave the matter in abeyance and to keep as a prisoner the young murderer named Nomtesi, whom we call Klaas, with Harry and Yan Ko. Thus done and resolved in the hall of the Fort of Good Hope, in the presence of the aforementioned Kaapmans on the above date. Nou, Harry het nou gekommer gesê, ja, maar hy wil nou ook sy traan nou klaarmaak, wat sê Jan vir hom, wow, 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 ons gaan later jou trial uitsort, wag jy net eers. Hy wil allemaal eens onder vier oor kry. Nou, daar is ons nou 10 beeste en 9 skaap, as ek het nie mis het. Presented the commander with 10 fine head of cattle and 9 fine sheep. Hoor nou die story. Fine lovely weather. Early in the morning the Kaapmans brought their aforesaid gifts, en natuurlijk 19 stuk vee al te saam, to the fort and drove the animals among those of the company. Thereupon they again came to the hall and claimed that among the cattle we had taken from Harry were 48 belonging to the following parties. So, ek weet nie wat die gebeur het hier. Hoekom sal jy 10 vee vir die ou gee en dan stryd vir die ou sê, okay, hier is vir jou 10 vee, maar jy skuld ons 48. Ga jy nie stryd na die ou toe gaan en sê, ja, maar jy skuld ons al vir jou 10 male gee, maar jy skuld ons dan 38 nie. Dan sê hulle hier so, 2 to Oshinkima or Shasher, 32 to the 3 sons of the Hottentot named Krontumsa Ketcha, who had been killed, 15 to Dohol, 8 to Duda and 9 to Iuchuchuebe. Iuchuebe. Ek gaan nie die naam op die uitspreek, dis te veel. In elk geval, daar is 48 al te saam. We replied that we considered everything found in Harry's camp to be his property, and that it was not sufficient to recoup us for our losses in copper and cattle. After a lengthy discussion, it was eventually agreed that they should content themselves with the following. Dan gee hulle 2 melkkoeie vir die ou, dan 2 koeie vir elkeen van daardie ouens, dan jy weet so 1 of 2 kies, making a total of 12, so hulle 12 teruggegee. Hulle 10 koeie % gekry en hulle het 12 weer uitgedeel, so Jan het basis 2 koeie weggegee. After these negotiations, they were asked that what should now be done with Harry, for which they replied that they had delivered him into our hands, but if we set him free, Shasher would attack him with assegais. They, however, preferred that we should deal with him as we thought fit, because he had harmed us by the murder of David, about which he had been overjoyed. On being asked whether they and the other natives would not be dissatisfied with us if we should kill Harry, they replied that we could do with him as we liked and withhold all the cattle and sheep from him and his people, as they really belonged to the company. Thereafter they were liberally treated to bread and brandy and presented with copper, tobacco and pipes, whereupon they left for their encampment situated to the east of the Salt River, within sight of the fort at a distance of a good hour's walk. Nou, maar daar het julle dit. Die skik net laat my so klein bietjie eensydig geklink. Nou, dis definitief 'n Kaapman ou wat doodgeskiet is, wat Harry se vee geverdedig het. Maar nou hoor ons nou, maar dit was ander mense sin gewees. Dalk het hierdie vrouens 'n kans gekom vat. Mens weet ookie. Ek lees maar net wat in die boek staan. Ek kan nou maar net aannames maak en so aan 'n bietjie pander. Wat dink julle? Dink julle die woorde wat hier staan is wet en waarheid? Dis presies hoe dit gebeur het. goeie swinkie van my water. Dan vat ons hom verder. Die nanas kom nog, hier kom nog groot nanas. Oké, okay, hier so 'n stukkie oor die moord van David. Harry remained in confinement with Bohubo, the boy's murderer alias Simon and Jan Co. The Carpens offered to thrash the latter. The Carpens offered to thrash the latter tied to a stake, because when the Honorable Cunius was here, he had stolen 15 sheep and brought them to Harry. The commander, however, wished to postpone this matter so that a closer investigation might be made and the innocent acquitted and liberated. Dumont had said that Coe had been an accomplice in the murder of the boy David, together with Bohubo, whom we call Simon, and another named Klaas, now out of the way, who is called Harry's son, a big, strong fellow. The following persons were this evening betrothed. Ek kom ons hou weer troue. En ons sien hierso, dit is Jan Zacharias of Amsterdam, wat trou met Maria, born in Bengal, 20 years of age, former female slave of the sick comforter Pieter van der Stel. She had been bought into freedom by the said Jan Zacharias for this purpose. Hulle sê so, Maria not only understands Dutch perfectly, but speaks it clearly and already has a fair knowledge of Christ according to the Reformed religion. Nummer 2, daar het hulle dit. En dis nou eers die bands wat gepublish word. Jy weet mos, hulle publiseer dit eers en dan so 'n paar weke na dit, ek dink 3 of 4 weke, dan is die eindelike troue nou. Dan is die eindelike troue. So nou, ons het nou gesien dat die veegeloop haal was, wat oorspronkelijk gedink is, dit is net Harry se vee, en toe kom die Kaapmans na, het sê, ja, maar die 50 van die vee, 48 van die vee, is ons in gewees, die ander is Harry's in. Fine, lovely, sunny weather in the morning, the cattle were counted and found to number 227 in all, both young and old. From this we deducted the number the honorable company had originally possessed, but 117 is, leaving 110. Dit beteken hulle het 110 beeste wins geslaan by Harry, which represented the number from Harry, valued at 5 gulden per head, practically the purchase price. They were worth 550 gulden plus 260 sheep at 25 stivers each. That is 325 gulden, making a total value of 875 gulden. The value of what he had stolen from the honorable company was calculated in order to set it off against the above amount. 43 head of cattle at 5 gulden each. The following articles entrusted to him for buying cattle in the interior, for which he delivered only 10 head of cattle, the rest being misappropriated to himself. Nou 400 pond koper teen 50 gulden per 100 pond. Daar gee hulle hele lys van al die goed wat hulle nou weet weggegee het vir hom wat verdwyn het. Dan sê hulle, making a total of 500 gulden. This value, when deducted from the above-mentioned figure of 875, leaves 375 gulden as compensation for the loss suffered by the honorable company through interference with the increase. Nou, maar hier is nou waar die ding vir my al hoe meer eensydig, hierdie skikking wat bereik is. Dit lyk vir my al hoe meer eensydig. Harry was accordingly told that there was no intention to return anything to him, as it was estimated that what had been recovered was less than what would have occurred to us from the increase of the livestock, while the question of the murder of the boy had yet to be settled and was not forgotten. Jy het net nog gesê, ja, maar hierso is die moordenaar. Toe sê hulle, ja, maar ander dag eers. Hierso is nou Eva teen Toman. En ons gaan nou in alliantie met die Kaapmans. After the ceremony today, the articles of peace negotiated with the Kaapmans were read out and affixed everywhere. During the morning service, 60 or 70 Hottentots had been loitering nearby, intending to steal the cattle from the Honorable Company once more. But seeing that 25 or 26 stalwart soldiers guarding them, they retired as if they had merely come to have a look. The interpreter Eva was asked who they were and what this meant, and replied that they were Kaapmans who had come to spy how our cattle were guarded and were seeking an opportunity to steal them from us. She also said that the fat captain, Gogosua, had made peace merely to free his son, Oshinkima, or Shashir, and Osawua, and that they intended, when the commander and the sergeant went out to the grain fields or elsewhere, to seize the opportunity to kill them, because the commander had imprisoned Shashir, and the sergeant had killed their comrade in the encounter yesterday, whereafter, so they believed, they would be able to overpower the rest as well. On being asked about the honorable peace they had made, she said that it had been made with the mouth, but they had not meant what they said. When the interpreter Duman was told this, he flatly contradicted it and maintained that these were the intentions of Harry's people. He stated that the men seen nearby had been to collect mussels on the rocks at the beach behind the Lion Mountain when the tide was out. The two interpreters are therefore contradicting each other with the greatest vigor, with the result that we are discovering many things. Eva stated that the Kaapmans intended entering into a general alliance with the others in the interior for the purpose of attacking us together. We replied to Eva, we hope that they would come with many cattle so that our booty might be larger and that we were a match for all the Hottentots should they dare to attempt it, but that it would be better for them to observe the conditions of the treaty so that we might live as brethren and we had mutually agreed to do. To this Duman replied, yes, Mynheer, the Kaapmans wish to do so, and this will be evident when the ships arrive. From their supply of cattle and their invitation to other natives to come here to trade with the commander. Eva thereupon said, take care, Mynheer van Riebeeck. Duman lies and cajoles. Nou, smaak my cajoles beteken deceives. Duman lies and cajoles you, but I shall tell you the truth, for I overheard Shashir myself. If Mynheer releases Harry and allows him to live at the fort with 4 or 5 milk cows, his people will always assist you against the Kaapmans. She talks thus from devotion to her uncle Harry, so that no credence can be given to it. Duman's statements must likewise be treated with reserve. When the latter was asked who among the Kaapmans would accompany him when proceeding to board ships on arrival here for the purpose of obtaining bread, etc., he replied, Oshinkima, alias Shashir, or perhaps Kaihantima, who is an important headman of the chief of the Chinohukwas, often mentioned before and from whom the most cattle were obtained approximately 2 years ago. We therefore concluded that if Shashir dared to go aboard, we need not fear what Eva had communicated to us. Orders were nevertheless given for a good watch to be kept and proper care to be exercised everywhere. Nou maar die volgende stuk handel oor die Maria. Hulle gaan die Maria stuur hulle eers Batavia toe en dan van Batavia af moet hy Australië toe gaan. Maar op pad Batavia toe moet hulle 'n kaart teken van die hele Kaapgebied, die hele Skiereiland, as ook die hele Valsbaai tot by Kaap Agulhas. Dit is nou basis die instructies wat nou hier gegee word. Ek gaan nou nie deur alles vir julle lees nie. Kom ek maak het seker die stukkie was in fokus vir die mense wat wil graag saam lees. Die ouwens op die kyk weer kan hom ons maar net daar gaan pols. Is nogal een elle lange stuk. Maar ek ben daar eindig hy. O, koek. As hy. En hier gaan Harry nou Robben Island. Ons kon toch. Harry gaan nou Robben Island toe. Hy gaan nou ordentlik loop mang. Today the prisoner and former interpreter Harry was again brought before the council, and after a long examination, the names of his people were obtained from him. Nou sê hulle nou hier so Harry homself, Aushumahu, en al daardie ander mensekies, ek het dit neergeskryf, vir later. Bohubo is ook hier so. Maar julle sien hier so, Harry's chief servant, according to Harry's confession, the murderers of the boy David, but out of reach and not to be found. Hemuau Katima. Dit is die ou wie Harry sê is die main instigator, maar die ander mense sê Bohubo alias Simon, also though doubtful, suspected of the said murder and both therefore imprisoned with Harry. En dan ook Tu Makakua, who a short while ago received a charge of shot in the buttocks from the sergeant. So die een oukie wat doodgeskiet is, is 'n kapen gewees, en die oukie wat in die bout geskiet is, is 'n strandloper. Harry stated at his excuse that the Carpens and others could not bear him from sheer hatred and envy, because he alone was usually allowed to board ships and permitted to obtain. Skoon toch man. Dit lyk beter. Permitted to obtain bread and other things therefrom. On this account, the Carpens had ruined his camp and robbed him of all his possessions on 4 occasions, and the Gorachohukwas once. He therefore asked permission to live in a hut near the fort with his wives and 3 or 4 milk cows and sheep, as he had been allowed to do when we first arrived here, and that he might again serve us as interpreter. Is in die was nou oorspronkelijk vir hom gegee gewees? Hy het gereach for the stars. Hy het by die maatskappy gesteel, en toe kom hy, die ander groepe, toe boelie hulle om, en nou pleit die ou weer, ja maar, hy wil nou graag hee, dit moet nou weer wees as ou tye, jy weet, hy is nou weer een soet sienkie. But as the man had told us that Harry had struck the first blow at the murdered boy David 5 years ago, and the chiefs of the Carpens and all the natives, on being questioned about it, agreed that he had been the cause of all the evil and misunderstanding, it was at length resolved to convey him to the Robben Island at the first opportunity with the other Hottentot prisoners mentioned, namely Kajmai alias Janko and Bohubo alias Simon, as hostages to promise them that they would be released as soon as the real murderers had been delivered to us. Resolved also as regards Harry to await the instructions of our Lord's principles with regard to the disposal of his person. But should he desire to have his wives and hut also removed there, to accede to his request. Finally, to make known all our decisions to the Carpens and all the other natives. So dit is nou duidelik. Jan van Riebeeck is nou, hulle sluit nou 'n alliansie met die Kaapmans en hulle is nou half teen Harry en so aan. Hulle het nou Harry se grond gevat. Though peace had been concluded with the Kaapmans, it was decided to retain 20 soldiers who had been drafted on shore from the Prince Willem for the present to strengthen the garrison until the arrival of the first ships from the fatherland, expected in 4 to 6 weeks, not knowing what plots the natives might hatch or what their intentions were. It was also decided to offer peace to all Harry's people and to the Watermen as soon as Harry had been removed to the island, in order to be clear of all enemies and to enable us to journey everywhere in safety, and if we should suffer injury from anyone, to claim compensation for breach of alliance. En hier begin ons praat ons nou oor Robben Eiland, maar hierdie gaan meer oor bemesting. Daar is wel so 'n stukkie in van ander goed, die mense wat, is echt nog 'n interessante stukkie, hierdie van die bemesting. As much green grass and clover sods as the vessel could carry. So hulle, Jan sê nou, elke keer wanneer daar 'n bootjie oorgaan, dan moet hulle 'n klomp misstof oorvat, en daar so die grond ryker maak. Dan hier so is promosies. O, ja. Die mense wat daar wil saamlees. Ek is nie te veel gepla oor die. Hierdie Jan Zacharias. Hy sê ou wat met die slavin van Bengal trou. Freeman and resident at the fort who is serving as cook to the junior merchant. Daar word hy ook gepromote. Hoe kry jy 'n Freeman promotion? Julle kan gaan daar gaan lees en uitvind. Ek dink voor ons nou nog verder gaan. Dis nou hoogtyd vir nog so 'n laaste sigaretjie, dan vat ons nog so 'n stukkie. Ek hoop jy het te veel oor. Mense is al amper 10 uur. Dis al amper 10 uur. Jy sien ek het nog net een sigaret gerook. Ek moet nog my vars pakkie oopmaak. Kraak vars, Stuyvesant. Beslis poetic liberties en die een goeie ding van die load shedding is, die load shedding los my met geen ander opsie nie. Ek kan seker weet, hier en daar een of ander twee goeikies doen, maar hier is nie krag nie, wat doen jy? Jy sit en lees maar. So ek het gelukkig kans gehad om hierdie storiekie twee keer deur te lees. Kom ek lig op my boude, wat is swing van my water. Dan sal ek, gou daar storiekie nip. Joeg, my lyf is nie gelukkig met my nie. Omdat het so laat is, ek moes al in die bed gewees het. Is dit my lyf deur torture vir julle? Kom my eierklankie nou weer deur my neus. Okay, let's go. op die desktop. As the commander had hinted to the man yesterday that if the weather was fine today, he intended visiting the chief of the Karpmans in his camp on the east or other side of the Salt River. This chief sent one of his sons to ask the commander to come today, as he intended moving his camp to the Leopard Mountain tomorrow, natuurlijk Tygerberg, for the sake of new pastures. The reply was that the commander had not time today, but that he would visit Gogosua often after his return. The messenger left with a present of tobacco and some brandy in a can. Hier was nou die groot ou. Op die 10de, fine, lovely, warm, sunny. So was nou eers by die 10de mense. Hierdie stuk gaan verskriklik lank aan. Fine, lovely, warm, sunny weather and variable breeze in the morning. About 9 o'clock, the ex-interpreter, or as the English used to call him, King Harry, was removed in the Skarpenjacht from his kingdom in the furthest corner of Africa to the Robben Island with two of his comrades, the one named Jan Kou, who, whilst the Honorable Cuneus was here, stole 15 sheep from the Honorable Company, and the other Bohubo alias Simon, of whom it is rumored, although we have no proof of it, that he was one of those concerned in the murder of the boy 5 years ago. We have, however, been informed that the chief murderers have disappeared. Time will produce more certain information. As far as we can gather, the removal of the prisoners is agreeable to the natives. King Harry. Dis maak met die Kaap was Wakanda gewees. We were kings. The Skarpenjacht also took to the island. Okay, nou hier was nou bokke en so aan. After discharging Harry and the cargo, so hulle het nou vir Harry en sy twee makkers en die cargo het hulle nou afgelaai daarso. Praat hulle nou van scatter the hay op die grond en dan get more food for the sheep in due course. Net bemesting. With this also came the ex-interpreter Harry and the Hottentots, Jan Kou and Bohubo or Simon. Dit is nou die brief wat Jan van Riebeek vir wat Ryk Overhagen geskryf het. Dis mos Ryk Overhagen. Toe Ryk Overhagen. Hy's mos die ou wat by Jan Woutersen oorgevat het. Ek gaan nou praat oor daai storie ook. With this also come the ex-interpreter Harry and the Hottentots, Jan Kou and Bohubo or Simon, who are to be detained on the island and employed on such work as may suit their inclination, but they are not to be compelled by force to do anything. They are to search for their own food in the shape of penguins, eggs, clipfish, etc., as no provisions will be sent for them. If they are prepared to assist in herding of sheep, you are to give them some tobacco, but nothing else, and you are to let us know, that we may send them some bread or other food if they deserve it. Janko is a good fisherman, and you may encourage him to practice fishing. The others should be encouraged to look after the sheep or to do anything else to which they are most inclined. They are to be kept there and not sent on board any ship without our express orders. Nou hier praat ons nou verder oor Robben Island, wat ek net graag wil uitlig. Only after New Year shall you commence lighting your beacon fires. Hulle het nou die dag dat hulle vir Jan Woutersen gefire. As gevolg van, ja, maar hy het nou nie 'n goeie werk gedoen met die beacon fires nie. Maar dit smaak my hierdie nuwe golden boy. Het dit tot nou toe ook nog nie reg gedoen nie. En dit smaak my, moenie worry nie, begin eers volgende jaar daarmee. Ek het so half gevoel dat hierdie hele inhegtenisname in Harry en sy instigators oor te vat na Robben Island toe, want as Jan Woutersen nog daar was, sou Jan Woutersen moes gekyk het na Harry en die twee gevangenisse. Nou ek weet Jan Woutersen het met 'n slavin getrou, en ek dink half, Jan van Riebeeck het gevoel, hulle gaan nie, jy weet, die volk ordentlik verteenwoordig nie en so aan. Hulle het maar eerder probeer om vir Jan Woutersen te verwyder. Want ek het daardie tyd al gesien, dat daar word nie eintlik redes gegee nie, daar word so amper as wel redes opgemaak was, om vir Jan Woutersen te verwyder daarso. Ok, kom ek los hom net daar vir die mense wat wil saamlees. Dan, die volgende stukkie handel oor die pikke wyn. Nou met die pikke wyn het lelik seer gekry. She was torn from her anchors and thrown high up on the shore at night. So hulle moet nou eers die pikke wyn, die Vryburgers se skipie. Dis nou hier die ander storie, ek sê almal is so trots op die eerste Vryburger boere. Uit hierdie boek kan die mens duidelik sien, hulle het nie veel gewarry oor boer nie. Hulle was vissermanne, hulle was seemanne gewees. Ons is meer seemanne as wat ons boere is. Nou, die koning word verkondig. Today the interpreters Duman and Eva were told that now that Harry was away, they should tell all his people and the watermen to come to the fort at once if they wished to be included in the peace made with the Carpens. They were also instructed to tell Gogosua, chief of the Carpens, and Oshinkima, alias Sharsher, his eldest son, to come here so that they might be made chieftains over all and Harry's people and the watermen made their subjects, and to consider should the latter refuse to submit to this, how to proceed against them. This message Duman undertook to deliver, and both he and Eva were evidently well pleased with it. Ek weet, Eva het vir Harry en Harry se spannetjie verdedig. Maar dit smaak my, Eva soek vrede, weet, van al twee kante af. En dat is net omdat Harry haar oom is, omdat hy sy meer vir hom verdedig. Lovely weather as before, Duman and some other trusted Hottentots went to the camp of the Carpens for the above-mentioned purpose, but found that they had left for the Leopard Mountain to find new pastures for their cattle, wat daar net nou al gesê was, hulle gaan doen. En dan die volgende stuk, het gaan weer oor Robben Island en die bemesting, wat die nuwe Golden Boy, die nuwe gatkruiperkie, vir Jan van Riebeeck terugskryf. Ek het niks te interessant daar gevind nie. Julle kan maar daar deel lees. Hier gaan ons nou aan met Harry Mang. We will see whether the three Hottentots who came over on your honour's express instructions will herd the sheep properly. But already they complain that there is no food for them and that they have to look for it. If, however, they display any zeal, it will be communicated to your honour. We will also postpone lighting the beacon fires until after the new year and carry out your honour's earlier instructions. Hier praat hulle nou ook oor 'n klomp vee wat dood 30, 31, 32. Hulle het vir Jan Woutersen gefeier nou die dag. En dat, soos wat ek onthou, het daar baie, baie minder gevrek. As men die ou aan die stuur, maar dan smaak my hierdie ou as die Golden Boy. Nou praat hulle ook hierso van die verduidelik hy van, ja, maar gaan Harry hulle nie die skape vrek maak en so aan nie. The Hottentots rambling over the island in search of penguins and eggs came upon a dead sheep and on their return asked whether they might have it. They will not be able to seize other sheep under cover of this, as the two servants are with the sheep from daybreak until evening. When the stars come out, at night they sleep in the sheep shed. Please send the hut of the herds here. Nou maar, hy sê daar die skape sal veilig wees, want die skape slaap onder dak. En dan net so ons gepraat oor die hase, daar is nou 360 skape op die eiland. The white doe has littered again under the house. Nou natuurlijk die hase. En dan die skip Maria word weggestuur, as ek het nie mis het nie. Given her dispatches, ja. Maria word weggestuur. Nou, hier is nou die eerste trouwe. Dit is nou Wouter Cornelissen Mostert, wat met Hester Weyers trouw. Ons in die einde van die vorige episode, hulle die bands gepublish, en hier is die actual trouwe nou. Hier word dit bevestig. En daar word nou gefokus op verdediging ook. Mense, ek is nou al... Kom ons, kap gou hier laaste klein stukkie. Today the commander went out to inspect some of the Hottentot approaches. Maar ek gaan nou nie die alles lees nie. Hulle praat hier van die Liesbeek rivier en soos hulle net nou gesê het. Hulle beplan om hierdie die grens te maak, soos hulle vir die Kaapmans ook gesê het. Daar is die Liesbeek rivier tussen ons en hulle. Hierso sê hulle net dat some of the opinion that they have gone to fetch more men to attack us. Versterkings na Batavia. We have nevertheless considered it advisable to send 11 of the 20 soldiers drafted from the Prince Willem to Batavia. So van hierdie versterkings wat hulle getrek het van die skip af, stuur hulle nou weer terug. En hulle sê, daar so is mense wat noem dat die Kaapmans weer gaan aanval. Weer van die Robben Island. Ach, dit is nou maar net. Hy sê hier so, allow the Hottentots to eat the sheep found dead on the island. Nou sê Jan van Riebeek ook dat an exile from Batavia named Domingo of Bengal, who will be serviceable on the island, is also sent over. So hulle het die bandiet oorgestuur vir Ryk Overhagen. Domino Morgul, ek hoop jy is nog hierso. Hierso is nou die stukkie vir jou. Nog een stukkie vir jou. Kuma alias Jan, third son of Gogosua, sent by the latter, came to warn us to be on our guard, as they had heard that Harry's people intended to steal our cattle again. We told them that they might come, for they would be received with powder and lead, as our men had orders to shoot down any Hottentots who came near the cattle without a little flag from us, and then to bring them into the fort to find out what tribe they belonged. We were not inclined to trifle with this matter any longer, having shown them too much tolerance in the past and had decided not to stand any more annoyance from the Hottentots, though we had nothing but good intentions toward them. The Kaapmans were thereupon advised not to mix themselves up with any thieves, otherwise they would be treated similarly and also shot down. There was no reason to fear that Harry's people, consisting of only 9 or 10 men capable of bearing arms, would dare to undertake that alone. This was also communicated to Jan, and we therefore considered that if the attempt should be made on the cattle, others would be assisting. However, they were welcome to try if they wished. It was immaterial to us, and they would see what would happen to them. Ek dink dalk moet ek om hier so afsluit. Ons kan nou so 'n klein bietjie vorentoe spring. Hierdie is net van Robben Island, at present sheep 400 total. Hulle het 'n paar oorgestuur, hulle het natuurlik hierdie klomp buitgeslaan by Harry in die Kaapmans, so hulle het nou 'n klomp oorgestuur, stuk of 30, 40, en daar is nou 400 skape al te same op Robben Island. En dan hier is nou die troue van Jan Zacharias van Amsterdam, wat met Maria van Bengal trouw. Dat is nou die actual troue, is nou nie die band wat gepublished word. He. En hier beginne praat hulle nou van die verdediging van die Liesbeek rivier en boerdery met mielies, maar ek dink vanaand is dit nou genoeg. Ek het verder as dit gelees, maar dit is nou al amper 2 ure en ek gaan hom net daar los. Mense, is julle nog wakker aan daai kant? Dit is verskrikkelijk, verskrikkelijk stil hier so in die kleedskolom. Ek vind die boekie baie interessant, ek meen. Gogosua is duidelik 'n sleutelfiguur in die geskiedenis van die Kaap. Maar ek het nog net in die verlede, jy weet, van die hoofstroom narratief, nog net van Harry gehoor. En tot wat ek nog snaakser vind, is dat die links is wat die boek skryf, The Lie of 1652. Hulle fokus ook net op Harry. Die, om die kooi geskiedenis uit Harry's perspektief te skryf, is juist om het te skryf uit die Europese perspektief. Dit is duidelik dat Gogosua is die diknek in hierdie hele area. Harry was bannelinge geweest. Die rede hoekom Harry in die Kaap area was omdat die Kaapans nie op daardie tyd daar gekom wy het. Die Kaapans het hulle fees gehou tyd in hierdie area. Brand wy. En dan sodra die Kaapans nader gekom het, Harry en sy spannetjie geskuif. Dis maak my hier na die Hottentots Holland daar by Stellenbosch area. Tussen Stellenbosch en die Kaap self het hy geskuif. Ek meen, as die Kaapmans daai kant is, dan vlug hy, en dan as die Kaapmans hierdie kant toe kom, dan kom hy maar weer uit die pad uit. En toe Jan hulle hier so aankom, toe Harry niks gehad. Daar is een stuk waar hulle sê, het skaars klere gehad in sy lyf. Maar The Lie of 1652, ek weet nie hoekom hulle so maak, ek meen, verseker, ek meen, lig hierdie punte uit van, ons praat nie van Gogosua en daardie type mense in ons geskiedenis nie. Wat werkelijk so is, ons moet meer daarover praat, dan dat ons geskiedenis beter ken. Maar, om te sê dat, ja, maar daardie weergawe, die Harry weergawe van die geskiedenis verkeerd, en die Harry weergawe moet eindelijk so lyk, en dan een klomp liegstories daarop maak. Nee, meneer, ek kan dit nie verstaan nie. En ek het nou lekker gerend. Kijk hier zo. Ek wil vir julle sê baie dankie dat julle ingeskakel het. Onthou, daar is absoluut geen skaamte daarin om jou kop uit jou gat uit te trek nie. Staan op vir daardie mense wat vir jou opstaan. En soos altyd volhard in. Hou koers.